landlocked San Luis between two gigantic powerful countries, China and Nepal, but it maintains very good interrelation with them. Psychology is first introduced in Trichandra College. When I was a student, that time it was considered as a doormat subject, and the growth was very slow and erratic. People are engaged only in public services or the Trivandrum University work. Trivandrum University was established in 1959, and the first of all, the psychology was introduced in the Department of the Education. And the same year, laboratory higher secondary school was erected for the application of psychology in classroom learning and the teaching practices. Public commission was and is still a single government body where psychologists has been employed for the application of psychological testing for the personnel selection. Similarly, military organizations, they do have some personnel trained in psychological testing. They use it for the army recruitment procedure. At present, psychology is the academic sector, master in psychology and counseling psychology, MPhil in clinical psychology are introduced. Right now, psychology papers has been taught in nursing, sports, tourism, hospitality, film institute, and management faculty, etc. Mental health sector and psychology. The Beer Hospital was established in 1989, but OPD, psychiatric OPD outpatient department was opened in Beer Hospital in 1961. And another OPD for the psychiatric services is opened in Trivandrum Chandra Military Hospital in 1972. 1989, the department of the psychiatry was shifted to Laganchel Mental Hospital, and it was transformed in a very big mental hospital, and it is the only one mental hospital in Nepal. Psychological services started. It is started, the services are started by Father Gaffney for the first time to provide first time established the rehabilitation center for the drug abusers. And our professor, late professor, Professor Sarvagya Narayan Shrestha opened the first psychotherapeutic clinic in 1980s with the combination of the psychotherapy which he used was combination of the Eastern and Western, probably Ayurvedic also. 1997, the first clinical psychological services started in public hospital at Trivandrum University Teaching Hospital by introducing MPhil in clinical psychology under the management of Nimhans. One of the initiator and the supervisor of that time was Professor Malini Kakapur is present here. She has done a very good deed for the student of psychology. Malavika Kapoor, please receive my sincere gratitude. Trivandrum University Teaching Hospital was erected and it is used 1997, the clinical psychological services. Applied psychology, in those fields, the applied psychology is applied, community-based social and mental health, school-based mental health program, trauma counseling and training and services and stress management. Beginning of psychological program in 90s, with the joint venture of Richmond Fellowship and the Trevor University. The school-based mental health program is now it is flourished, and many psychologists are employed in this as a school psychologist. After the research evidence shows there are a lot of problem, economic, social, emotional adjustment problem with the school students, school goers, and they work as a preventive and curative level. Psychological services at the community level. For 30 years, the NGO and INGO are working with the crisis of the Bhutanese refugee in the eastern part of the Japa. In 1990 and 1996, they provide them psychological services. Mostly the NGO, TPO, and the CIBICT, Center for Victim of Torture. During a decade along the Maoist insurgency 1996 to 2006, because of the civil conflict and government of Nepal, there has been a rapid growth of the mental health and psychosocial support programs, including the post-traumatic disorder and treatment of the Nepalese and the ethnic Nepali Bhutanese even. Nepal government has also emphasized the role of the psychological science to reduce the mental health gap by providing medical and psychosocial services at the rural community in collaboration with the government hospital and the primary health care center, but it is not implemented all over the Nepal. Still, it is not implemented all over Nepal. Mostly the center are those NGO, ANGO, and the hospital are centered in the Kathmandu Valley only. And those people who worked in the post-traumatic and the traumatic in the rural setting, they have given the door-to-door counseling services. And traditional counseling and psychotherapies in the cultural context, because Nepali people are not much educated, most are illiterate. That's why we have to understand to provide mental health services to them in their own model, and listening to them and understanding their idiom of distress. Nepali idiom of distress related to Nepali conception of the self, which are divided into the brain mind, heart mind, physical body, soul, and spirit, and social status. This is ethnological studies of Nepalese mind. Heart mind, it is the locus of memory and emotions. It is located in the chest regions, and it makes the person a unique identification through his or her wishes and desires. In contrast, the brain mind, the dimag, heart mind is the man, dimag, brain mind. In contrast, the brain mind is the organ of the cognitions, attention, and social regulation. And the brain mind, the relation between brain mind and heart mind is very, very crucial in the treatment of mental health. Brain mind located in the brain, and whenever it is working appropriately, there is no disturbance in the mental health. But when it walks abruptly or abnormally, then the people becomes ill. And one of the problem we call it's a result of the brain mind malfunctioning, the violence and uncontrolled anger are the examples of brain mind problems. Lastly, the major mental disorder and psychosis are the examples of the brain-mind problems. Spirit. The another relations with the manche, the person is affected by those circle spirit, the sato. Sato is somehow synonymous with soul, atma. But the sato is a spirit. It is within a person and connected with the supernatural world of the ancestor. And the existence of the sato is very crucial for vitality and the physical health. There should be a relationship between the heart mind and the brain mind. If there is a problem with the heart mind and the brain mind, the sato has gone, the lost or fly away somewhere, and the person may be the vulnerable to the physical maladies, and the community people or the family member, they seek help with the jhami jhakri, a salmon, to call back sato bolaunu in Nepali, sato bolaunu, and to restore the health and the vitality. And the sato, sometimes it is lost, like a soul has lost. It is a problem. If it is lost, then it is a problem. If it fly away, we can call it. And I have read a very good expression 2 months back in the social media. I don't know what do it mean, but I love it. पहले आदमी मरते थे और आत्माएं भटकती थी, पर अब आत्माएं भटकती है और आत्माएं मर जाती है और आदमी भटकते हैं. We think about it. And the physical body is a site of the suffering and pain. The pain and the suffering of the people related to heart mind, and when they are suffered, the heart mind can be the worries are added to the heart mind, but sometimes the heart mind worries translated to the physical body symptoms, that is a somatic symptoms. In our language we do have our own idiom of distress, that is gastric. For the abdomen pain, we say gastric. And when we do have a tingling sensation in the body, we say jham jham, jham jham aunu. And it is very very unique. The heart is located in the epicentric area of the stomach, and whenever we are very worried, and we feel the heart will coming out through the mouth. Okay. In this way, if it is intact, the mental health can be maintained. Okay, psychosocial counseling is provided by the counselor in 2005, the devastated earthquake, integration of the mental health and the psychosocial support in emergency time, it is recognized as an essential relief strategy. Psychosocial care support and the counseling in emergency, these are the place where the earthquake affected area and the crisis, and they provided the services in those circled area and the colorful. The TPU have given the intervention in those field, alcohol abuse, these are the figurate TPO intervention, male and female, with the individual psychosocial counseling support or the group psychosocial counseling support and family counseling support. And this is the emergency period in 2015 and provided the PFA. And we are providing individual career counseling, group counseling, expressive art therapy. Nepal Hypnosis Psychosocial Care is providing the different kinds of the psychotherapeutic services. EMDR, the trauma therapy, are provided during the emergency period. And most of the our NGO and INGO are provided the systemic therapy, the family therapy. Psychoeducational intervention are given to the grassroots level, and the Sadak Natak, which is very, it plays a prominent role for the psychoeducation, the street drama. These are the organization mental health in Nepal, which worked in Nepal for providing different kinds of the psychological support, psychological, they use the psychological assessment, and the, they did the treatment for the grassroots level and in the village or in metropolitan city even. These all are here. And the last I would like to say, the TSO, the School of Psychology, work on the suicide prevention and intervention and postvention. The president of the TSO is in the present here, Dr. Narendra Singh Thaguna. And we do have a challenges. Some challenges we in Kathmandu, in Nepal, that is the man-made crisis, natural disaster like flooding, landslide, humanitarian crisis, internal political and social cultural conflicts between people of Nepal and hill area. Maoist insurgency resulting psychosocial mental health consequences along with the natural disaster. Climate change is another major factor in Nepal's vulnerability to disaster, armed conflict and terrorism. On the social cultural level, that is the most prominent problem is the massive internal force displacement, social, political, economic and gender-based discrimination and violence, sexual orientation, violence against the minority, marginalized group, and historical problem in multicultural setting of Nepal. These are the challenges we meet. And the weakness and strength, Nepal has been facing enormous problems, but there are a very few psychologists and limited skilled intellectual. We can count the doctor of the psychology, there were 17, and two of them are completing their doctorate from Australia and Korea. Despite of the major challenges and limited resources, Nepalese psychology is committed to improve the status of psychology in both academic and applied fields. Clinical psychology and counseling psychology has made a great contribution to reduce human suffering. There are some associations who are working to meet the challenge as coming out from the problems. Those are the well-known association are the NPA, 1982. Now it is phased out. Nepalese Psychology Association established in 2010, and it works to some extent, but it is remain idle. And Nepalese Psychological Association established in 2015 in the emergency period, but it is now keep silence. And the Association of Psychologists Nepal established APN 2016 after the emergency period, doing a lot of homeworks during the emergency period, and report to the APA and to the support, financial support of the APA, this association was established. We have done some works like that. This one, during the 2015, during our emergency period, Nepal Disaster Specialist Education Program with support of Japan, Israel. I'm coming summing up. And another one is the with the support of the Caritas Italian, providing psychosocial support and care to the survivors of the Sindhu Palchak and the Pokhara. And we are participated, after opening this one, we participated as a panelist for the future of the psychology in international perspective, Washington, D.C. And another Southeast Regional Conference for the to develop the psychological testing for the Southeast Asia. And the participate as an international observer and participate in the frontiers of the psychology, who is the organizer is here, Professor Bookshin Han. And I'm thankful to your invitation. And the work now, we are working supervisor and stakeholder for the post-traumatic disaster maintenance with Israel, JISP, and Metropolitan Kathmandu. And we work in climate change special program in IIP and work in the task force terrorism. And the main purpose of this task force is better understanding for how psychology contribute to addressing the terrorism and the consequences. Our member are actively working with those areas. And the future of the applied psychology is Nepal. In my view, I have written this one. Priorities to solving the range of the human, social, cultural development problems, applied psychology is moving on to this direction. At last, not least, I would like to say, we are in borderline, in the development of the borderline, but we are doing something better than nothing. Thank you. Shukriya. Gracias.
Thank you, Professor.